Hello.
Hello.
We're doing. Well, I guess we should announce. We meant to do it yesterday.
Yeah, we were kind of lost in the novelty of starting Paper Mario Thousand Year Door.
Which will go up soon. Yes. So Banjo wasn't working out.
No, if you've noticed throughout the couple videos, it just kind of stops and hangs for a bit. And
yeah.
And that's kind of annoying. So we're stopping that for technical reasons.
Until we get a better rig. One that can handle the blast processing on the N64.
Or until we get the cartridge of it. Either way. I mean, that one, the latter is probably more unlikely, but yeah, we're aiming for... We'll try it again once we get a better rig.
They usually have it at that used games place nearby, but...
Usually. It's expensive, though.
It's like 30 bucks.
30 bucks, that's it?
But... I don't really want to dig out the N64 and everything.
Fair enough.
But we're doing Mario 64 and Spyro.
We're doing...
Since we started that, we figure we'll just start pairing those up now and again.
Yep. So, what you missed, we missed a discussion. We were talking... We just finished...
the filler episode of DBZ, Krillin's proposal.
Yes, and a discussion came up afterwards, just like... What does everybody do for money? Money's never really an issue for the heroes in Dragon Ball Z.
Nope, never ever.
Yeah, so we were like... So we know that from what we see of Yamcha in, like, between scenes, he's a baseball player in his spare time.
Yeah, he's the only one with a regular confirmed job.
And Bulma, if you stretch it, she's like the princess ahead of a multi-billion Zinni corporation, so...
No, she always had all the free time in the world, though, so I think she's just taken care of by Daddy.
Yeah, she's getting Daddy's rich... whatever. Not to mention that... also, she's smart, so maybe she, like, invents some stuff on the side, but the point is, she's got... That's how she takes care of herself. That's how she's able to afford all that shit.
Okay, Mario's taking a long time to boot up for some reason.
Yeah. I hope it's not. I hope nothing bad happened to it.
Krillin was the big mystery.
Yeah, he always seems to have Oh, it's already running. You might want to just go into like the console. Or there it goes. Okay.
I tried to launch it twice and it like overlapped each other.
Yeah.
We're good now though.
It's me, Mario.
As you can hear, we're good.
Hello.
Yeah, Krillin during that arc just kind of had a tuxedo for no reason.
He just suddenly acted like he had a lot of money in the Garlic Jr. arc.
Yeah. So,
do you think the whole arc was just like a dream in Krillin's head?
No. Because a dream just ends. A dream doesn't end with him breaking up with a chick.
Well, maybe it was a really elaborate dream. Wow, we're already at 43 stars.
Yeah. Are we?
Yeah. So we're a third of the way through the game.
Are you serious?
We're a third of the way through the game.
What was the last level we did?
We haven't started the basement levels yet.
Oh. We did Ghost House, right?
Yes.
And we just finished the top one.
Yes.
Oh, this is gonna be, it's a good thing we paired this up with Spyro.
Why?
Because that's also a short game? Question mark?
Yeah, Spyro is... Wait, did we only do one Super Mario video, or we did two, right?
We did two.
Okay.
This isn't our first one, no.
So this will probably take six playthroughs, or six videos to finish.
Makes sense.
Whereas, Spyro, we're through two of five worlds, so I think we'll get through that in five, probably.
Yeah, that makes sense. So, this will be the last thing, and then I guess after that I can throw in another extra long game. Oh, what are you doing?
I don't know. I guess the levels are fine. I'm still thinking of if there's any way we can get rid of the surrounding box, because we changed modes at some point in Paper Mario 1.
Oh, he did?
And I don't remember if
it was like having graphical issues with the first mode was the reason or what.
You can switch it back if you think it'll help. I mean, take the time to do
it. Let me try it.
I'll just continue.
Talking about Z characters.
Yes. So Krillin, inexplicable amount of money. I thought maybe he like invested in some nightclubs or something.
Yeah.
But yeah, he's got enough of it that he's able to like attract this floozy with all the gifts she could ever want.
Yeah. I mean, my theory was that they were like treasure hunters on the side. Because they had the previous experience with the Dragon Ball hunting, so why not? I mean, they were looking for that pearl like it was no business.
Yeah. I guess that would. It's just weird how people are just saying about Krillin, like, oh yeah, Krillin, he can buy stuff. By the way, what do you do, Krillin? I don't want to talk about it.
Okay, that's not working.
I know that, okay, also Tien and Chiaotzu live off the land because they're nomads.
Yeah, they're just nomads, and Piccolo
or apparently Chiaotzu's an emperor, depending on what you watch.
Something like that,
Emperor
yeah.
Chiaotzu! I love that movie!
Yeah.
Okay, so for those of you unfamiliar with Dragon Ball, there was like the Dragon Ball series, and then there was like some Dragon Ball movies, and the movies are in their own separate thing. Well, three of the movies. The fourth one is another its own separate thing. Everything okay?
Yeah, yeah. There's no way we can't change it. I think it's because of the graphics processor, whatever the thing we're using for the N64, the
Project 64.
The format.
Alas, we'll endure. We've always have.
Because of the graphical issues, we changed to a different. I can't think of the word, but you know what I mean.
Processor?
No.
Mode?
No.
Engine?
Something like that. Yeah.
Driver?
Driver, probably.
Okay.
Underground Lake. That's where we're headed. Oh, this level sucks for the 100 coins.
This level sucks. Yes, you could have stopped there.
Yeah.
Yeah, I've never liked
Fuck.
This. I've never
Get
liked
up,
this.
Mario!
I've never liked this level.
No. Like, I don't think many people do.
Oh, maze! Nothing's more fun than getting lost.
In a cave, where everything looks
with
the
same. With a box of scraps.
Ow.
Ah,
fuck this.
Yeah, good job. Here we go! So, is it the last star?
I don't know, maybe.
It's course 6 of the... Watch for...
No, this is level 6.
Okay, yeah, course 6. Oh, that was number...
I guess that was star 6.
Wow. Just jumping straight to the end.
Goku was also kind of a mystery because, I mean, the way Abridged handles it is that just they're getting all the money from Chi-Chi's dad, the Ox King, who is obviously rich.
Which makes sense. I mean...
It makes sense,
yeah. It's a plausible explanation. Like, how are you able to afford your lifestyle? Oh, I mooch off my father-in-law? Okay, seems legit.
I didn't say it wasn't plausible, just that it was never explicitly confirmed in the canon series.
Yeah. I mean, I also posited the fact that, okay, what's Goku's skill set? He can fight pretty well. He eats really well. He's a hunter. He,
yeah.
like, hunts meals.
Well, I mean,
and
we
sells.
See him hunting all the time, so
yeah.
obviously he supplements his income with that.
Yeah, just, like, he hunts and he sells it to, like, butchers and stuff.
Well, no, I just meant he hunts for his own food, so.
Okay.
Hunter and gatherer.
Well, I mean, if he... Well, how do they afford all those books, then? What does Chi-Chi do?
I'm
she
sure
just
that,
stays
well,
at
that,
home and just kind of...
Well, that's Chi-Chi money. Goku is the breadwinner. He earns the food.
Oh, hey, it's Nessie.
Oh, we teleported again.
Yeah, yeah. That happened to me before. I'm not surprised by that. Yeah.
Goku's in charge of the food. Chi-Chi's in charge of everything else.
In charge of the finances, huh?
Well, yeah. The money.
Yeah.
The people money.
Nessie, thank you. Or no, it was Tessie.
I think it is Nessie. I don't know, though.
Yeah, it is Nessie, you're right. I was thinking someone else, but our... Super Mario Brothers Z. That was a thing.
Yeah, it was.
Yes. It had the same, like, music, too.
Yeah.
Like, the cool-ass Dragon Ball Z music.
Da-da-da-da-da-da-da!
Yeah! That's become iconic.
Yeah.
They don't, of course, they don't, like, do that anymore.
We started watching this run-through of DBZ with the original Japanese soundtrack.
But then I realized it's like exactly the same as the Dragon Ball soundtrack, and I've already listened to Dragon Ball, so I'm just like, okay.
It's kind of boring.
Yeah. Well,
comparatively, in a lot of cases.
Oh, compared to a series with like Dragon Ball Z, where everybody's just kind of like teleporting around, beating the shit out of each other, firing energy blasts.
Yeah.
It's just like.
Okay, now we gotta find the metal area. I probably should have looked at the map.
You probably should have. It's fine. I don't blame you. We'll get through this eventually.
There's a door. Probably not the door. Ow!
Let's do another star. Just take it. I mean...
Yeah. We need to get the, Oh, wait. No, I think I remember where the metal thing is. It's not in the maze.
Oh, really?
Okay, I think I know where I'm going now. So we'll get this star, and then we'll come back, because I think we do need the metal, or it makes it easier to get the 100 coins.
Ah.
Yep, we've been here.
I like how out of all the martial arts superheroes in Dragon Ball Z, only Yamcha's the one with, like, a verifiable cover identity.
Yeah.
Everybody else just kind of does their own thing.
Maybe they're all training all the time. Maybe that's why Yamcha's the weakest. Well, no, he's not the... Chiaotzu's still the weakest.
Yeah.
I wonder if Chiaotzu stopped training, or if he's just
He trains
bad.
His mind.
Maybe.
I mean, he's shorter than Krillin.
Yeah.
So, it's like Krillin has to, like, had to train to adapt to his, like, weakness of being so fucking short.
Yeah.
Chiaotzu's even smaller than that. There's not much muscle you can add on to that.
I guess.
It'd be better for him to, like, train up his psychic abilities to the point where he could just find an ultra-powerful foe and just hack into his mind and, like, make him forget how to breathe or something.
But he doesn't.
Yeah, Chiaotzu's kind of an idiot. I'll punch him!
I think Chiaotzu more or less just becomes a cook.
Yeah, welcome to Emperor Chiaotzu's
finest Chinese restaurant in Dragon Ball. What's in China?
They're...
We're looking for a tall native man.
I love that fucking... We're looking for a tall native man. And the guy was like, you know, a Native American looking dude. But there's no America in Dragon Ball Earth,
yeah.
Dragon Ball Earth is weird. It's got... It's not even got really like a centralized government or anything.
No, it's got a single continent with like five major cities on it.
And a metric fuck ton of islands.
Yeah. And then there's Yanzibit Heights. And that snow place where Muscle Tower is, that's its own island.
Oh, yeah, that... It's like those pirates from Dragon Ball, One Piece, really missed the continent.
Yeah.
Oh, there is a giant island, but we don't fuck with that.
I think Dragon Ball Universe has a pretty even distribution of water to sea. Like, it's 50-50 as opposed to our Earth's 30-70.
30%, like,
or
drinkable.
One Piece is probably 90-10. Not a lot of
95-5!
Yeah.
Like, I imagine the distillery business in One Piece is, like, really popular.
Yeah.
Like, that's something that'll never go out of style, turning seawater into freshwater.
Alright, here we go.
We distilled the fuck out of this sea. I mean, the most popular salt... Most of the salt we have... Here we go. The metal base.
Invincible!
This is how we unlock
the last cap.
Yep.
Ow. Well, that's one way to pull it.
Yeah! Metal caps make you indestructible. Well, not in this game, yes, but
invincible
not
to damage. Oh, and I forgot to get the thing.
Forgot the metal cap! You fool!
Was there one up there?
Yes.
Okay, there is. I'm having flashbacks to that really shitty part of Zelda where you had to avoid falling in the sinkholes with the iron boots.
Oh, gosh.
That was in everyone's favorite temple, the water temple.
A rallying cry of everybody in Legend of Zelda was, when we played, like, Ocarina of Time, was fuck the water temple.
Yeah.
Hey,
you hate the water temple. Well, wait till you see what we have for you in the sequel.
Pickle. I just remember what you talked about. That, okay, here's the thing about the water temple. You can afford, you have the time to fuck up in the water temple. Not so much that place in Majora's Mask.
The Great Bay Temple.
Yeah, you fuck up in Great Bay Temple. You're not gonna have time to do anything other than complete the temple and fucking reset.
Yeah.
You know, it's a good thing you can teleport straight to bosses in that game.
Yeah, saved a lot of headache for later cycles.
Later cycles, you had to go and like complete all the major side quests.
Ah! Body tackle. All games are better with body tackles.
Yeah, I mean, Banjo-Kazooie was pretty good game because of its rolling tackle. I'm still disappointed we can't finish that.
We'll get to it. We will return to Banjo when equipment allows.
We only did two episodes of it, and I ended up getting mad at you for one of them. Alright. Oh, with metal, you can breathe and gas.
You don't need to breathe.
So, speaking of being turned into metal, there is this, you're familiar with the game Tomb Raider, right? You know that it exists. So there's this, level in Tomb Raider called King Midas's Temple, and...
Oh, I guess I'm not heavy enough to...
Yeah, it's stuck! So, in this temple, you had to, like, turn, like, multiple lead bars into...
Oh, fuck. Yeah, go on.
You had to turn multiple lead bars into gold bars to get to the level end.
Yeah.
And you did this by going to a giant fucking hand and just using the bars near them. However, if you were to jump on the metal hand, there would be this long scene in which Lara Croft from feet to head slowly gets turned into gold. And it sounded like one of the most agonizing things I've ever heard.
Yeah.
Because she just goes, "Aah! Aah!" I did it over and over because I was just so fascinated by how cruel it looked. This is back when I was like 12, by the way.
Yeah.
I was like, what the fuck? That's pretty rad. This is pretty metal.
So this is Deathclaw's favorite Mario game, right?
Because of the falling rocks, the climbing on the...
Because of the fact that you can turn metal.
We're here to make Mario metal. We will make everything metal.
Blacker than the blackest black. Times infinity!
We're kind of off sync there.
Well, yeah, he says it's slower than you were doing it. Ow. I can still get the star with the... Even though I missed one or two of the blue coins, it's just going to be less fun.
Tougher.
Yeah. Oh, there's nothing up here. Okay.
It's a psych out.
Way.
There you go.
It is kind of annoying that you can't collect 1-ups in this game until they finish their spinning.
Well, they don't want you to immediately grab them. Oh, I can still get hurt. Oh well. Yeah, you did it! You gained access to that area.
I gained access to 3 coins.
Gained access to Waterworld.
With Kevin Costner?
Have you seen Waterworld?
Nope.
Okay.
That's like
having answered that question, what do you think is the first scene in Waterworld?
I have no idea what the first scene is. It's about a flooding apocalypse, isn't it?
Oh, yeah, it's about like it's the world except water. What if water was more than people? So in Waterworld, the first scene is Kevin Costner on a fucking raft, and then he pisses into like a can, and then he pours the urine into a machine. The machine does its thing and it exports out a liquid, which he drinks.
Okay.
The first scene is him drinking his own fucking piss.
Okay. Sounds like a classy movie.
Oh, I forgot. You don't care about that.
Not really.
Like, normally with big budget movies like that, you start off with something like, I don't know, a pirate raid.
Yeah.
No, just him just drinking his piss. But yeah, that. And then the villain is like actually trying to bring civilization to this outlawed pirate land.
Oh, so he's Ganondorf.
Yes.
I want to unflood Hyrule.
Well,
how dare you, you fiend!
Yeah, you know, I will say
I'm gonna die. Nope.
I will say that that Ocarina of Time Ganon and Wind Waker Ganon are two separate people.
Yeah,
practically
they are.
Because Ocarina of Time Ganon is like, I'm evil. I want to rule everything. Meanwhile, Wind Waker Ganon's like, man, this entire ocean is flooded. Everybody who's ever caused me pain's been long dead. I'm gonna resurrect Hyrule. I'm gonna unflood this fucking ocean.
Get over here, you mad asshole.
And then I'll be king. And then fuck it, we'll just see what happens from there.
Yeah.
Does he even really do anything villainous in that? He kidnaps this one chick, but
he was trying to like kidnap the princess, yeah.
Oh, like Bowser? Yeah. He was as villainous as Bowser. That was like Jack Spite. He went from being like Berserk level ability to Jack Spicer level ability. I mean, there's nothing wrong with it. I liked Ganon's portrayal in Wind Waker as like,
yeah, as far as character development goes, that was easily the best Ganon.
Yeah. Dork. Also, he had two swords!
Yeah.
That was the final was boss cool. Is one of the best fucking final bosses. Because it's just two kids versus this guy with two swords and attitude.
Best Ganondorf fight. Wind Waker Ganondorf was the most Kenpachi-ish Ganondorf.
Oh, yeah. Also, it looked really cool.
Yeah.
Oh, this one. Oh, yeah. Be careful.
Well, I busted it out.
So much for... Fortunately, that resets.
Fortunately, yes. That would be a big oversight if it didn't.
So, Mario, we spent a lot of time talking about anime and Ganon and not enough talking about Mario. I wonder if people are actually seriously going to get angry about
no.
that. You're no talking about the game, you monsters! You should be ashamed of yourselves. Quit YouTube forever. Oh, can you actually stop it?
I guess.
Well, all the Mario jokes we've made, we've made in, like, Super Mario World.
Pretty much. I mean, we'll come up with more, but we don't have to talk about Mario constantly.
Of course not. No, talk about me constantly!
Just made me imagine Mario rubbing his nipples.
Oh, you gotta have to call that other plumber! Oh, I'm the only plumber! You gotta deal with me and Luigi!
I guess you'll just have to have the other human save you. Oh, wait, there aren't any other humans!
Wario doesn't give a shit about saving anybody. He just wants to be rich.
We gotta play Wario World.
Oh yeah.
We can do that after this game.
Yeah, we can do it.
We don't have sunshine.
Do you have sunshine?
No.
Damn it, we need
looking for it.
Yeah. Sounds like there's some trouble in paradise.
Mario, it's some kind of sludge.
I forgot if that Toad had that voice in that game. Everybody was voiced in that game. It was weird.
Yeah.
I'm saying weird, but it's not like weird in a totally bad way. It was just kind of unusual because
apparently there's voice acting in Galaxy too. So.
Oh, that'll be fun.
I don't know how much voice acting. I would imagine not quite as much as Sunshine, but. Also something that we need to play, because neither of us have ever played that. You've at least played Sunshine.
I've played Sunshine enough to kind of know how things go in that game. And that's not saying much, but...
Ow! Okay.
You're just having trouble with those right angles.
It's a little hard to do, like, depth in this game.
These hiccups are really kicking my ass.
You need to work on your diaphragm control, man!
Alas. Breath control! Alright, so, we did watch the death battle of, or at least I did, of Ganon versus Bowser.
Yeah, I haven't seen that one yet.
Okay, well, I have to say that the winner is, for the most part, unobjectionable.
Well, shit.
What?
Nah, I fell.
Okay. Oh, well, that's fine. It's okay to fall. You gotta get back up! Mario gets
knocked. I get knocked down, but I get up again! You're never gonna keep me down, Luigi!
You know what's funny?
You rich asshole!
You know what's funny?
What?
That band, Chumbawamba.
Yeah.
They were active for 20 years, and that was like one of their only like crossover hits in America.
Yeah.
The problem is that there's the music label they were on, the major label EMI. They hated EMI. They released an album explicitly called "Fuck EMI." And yet EMI signed them anyway.
As long as we're making money off
right,
it.
Yeah, you know what the band, when they were offered the contract, the band looked at them like, okay, sure. Yeah, okay. So then they had their hit, and they're like, yeah, Sally, that's a great experiment for us. And then they just kind of refused to work with the label after that.
Yeah.
And then they went back. It's great. I love moments like that where an anti-corporate dude is actually signed by that corporation. It's just like, hey, your talent's really good. You're like, you know I hate you and everything you stand for, right?
But you're still making me money!
I'm gonna continue.
Then Queen wrote a song about how they hated one of their former managers with a passion.
Oh.
That was Death on Two Legs. One of my favorite Queen songs.
Have I ever listened to that song?
I've played it in your presence before. I don't know if you knew that you were listening to it.
Probably not.
You're just calling him every kind of son of a bitch there is.
Fuck you, and the horse you rode in on it. One coin short!
I'm one coin short. So, either I have to hope there's like a bat or something in the maze, or I have to try and take out this asshole up here, which is nigh impossible.
You can do it. So,
wouldn't be a fun stream if there weren't any challenge.
Yeah, we're just coasting through this game. That's why Dark Souls streams are so popular.
Are they?
People love to see people struggle and overcome odds. That's why John Cena is so popular, because he made a career of overcoming the odds.
Mm. Well, I was playing F-Zero, but I kind of hit a standstill, so.
Really? You weren't able to finish it?
Well, I mean, it's a very hard game. Realize when I completed it took hours and hours and hours on end and playing nothing else. I'm trying to do the hardest thing in the game, so I might have to do some practicing off stream before I return to it.
Yeah, this game's of intense skill like that. At least with Dark Souls, you can kind of get the patterns down and stuff.
Yeah.
Okay. Get Operation Kill Everyone.
Who am I gonna kill? Is there a sniffet? There you are, you beautiful son of a bitch.
Come with me if you want to live.
Come with me if you want to die. Here we go. I want that coin. Oh, I didn't save.
Oh, you didn't save.
Whatever.
There's a power surge, you're gonna regret that.
Yeah, that would suck. Don't jinx us. Hello?
What are you doing?
Fuck off. I'm looking for the exit, the regular exit.
So,
follow my nose! That was a bad idea!
What if Billy Mays designed this area?
Okay, why him? What is your train of thought? I'll come with you on this adventure. What are you thinking?
Then it would be the Maze Maze.
All for a pun, was that it?
Yes.
What if it was also made of corn?
maze is corn maze.
And was inside
the maze. It was a maze of...
And was inside the maze bank.
A corn maze inside the maze bank made by Billy Mays? You're gonna have to give me a map. I can't get out of this mazeception. It's a five-dimensional maze.
And you go through it in maze. What was this star name? I wasn't paying attention. Metalhead Mario. Okay, that one.
There was actually... Okay, so there was a movie called Cube, and it was basically
Cube!
Like...
Gone.
It was basically like everybody was trapped in this cube, but it was a maze because some of the rooms that were in there were trapped, and nobody could tell which one was which, because all the rooms looked the fucking same except for some color differences.
Sounds like that museum in Bleach.
Oh, yeah. It was like, okay, it's like that, except three dimensions.
Yeah.
And everybody was not armed with shit.
They didn't have a string attached to a mod soul.
Oh, no! No! Okay, you know what they did early on in the movie?
What?
They, like, there's this guy who's, like, this prison escape expert, and is, like... And is like, okay, give me all your boots. He ties them, he just kind of throws them inside to try to trip any traps. Except one time it doesn't work, and the prison brick expert is the first to go.
Yeah?
Yeah, he's like...
Oh, that was almost bad.
Oh, that was almost, like, really tragic.
Come on! There we go.
Everybody's like, oh my god, you're the Rin! You can get out of any base. He's like, you can get out of any maze in prison. He's like, yeah, I'm Harry fucking Houdini. But you guys have got to watch out for yourselves. And immediately after that, he dies.
Now you can open the star door on the third floor. There's a third floor?
I'm in the basement!
Hurry along now.
Okay, 10 more stars and we can end this game.
Yeah, we could.
But we're not going to, because...
There is a glitch to get past the never-ending stairs. I have never been able to successfully perform it, though.
Oh, is that the next one? Is 6... Is that 7?
I think this is 7, and 8 is Sandland. Yeah.
7, you're right.
Boyle, the big bully. Don't be a pushover. I guess they felt like the bullies were a complicated enough enemy that they had to, like, add a little disclaimer at the start of the level. Like, there were kids going out there going, oh my god, these guys are invincible, they just don't die no matter what you do!
Yeah, the focus group, how's the focus group for Lethal Lava Land going? They all died! Oh shit, the enemy's too hard, we need to fix this! By the way, I guess the lava here doesn't, like, expel any fumes.
Nope.
The clean, you know, if they were to, like, do coal, like...
Clean burning lava?
Yeah, clean coal, yeah.
Thank you. Well, this makes the level easier.
Being able to fly to whatever platform you desire.
Platforming? Fuck that! Ah!
Hi! Hi!
I'm gonna kick your ass!
Okay, here's another question. Can you imagine Hank Hill as a superhero?
No. What would he be, Propane Man?
Or, like, he has fire powers?
Okay, I'm surprised that wasn't an episode, actually. Propane Man.
God, yeah, that would've been great!
I'm tired of seeing the cops ignore this. Time for some back city justice.
Propane. He doesn't have any good ideas, so he just dons an animal mask like an Hotline Miami. Who are you? I'm Propane Man. Why do you got a tiger mask on, Propane Man? Shut up! Can you hip drop him?
Yes. And that sends them really far.
Well, then you should do that. Is there teleports in this?
Yep.
Yeah, I knew it! Of course you did that before.
Oh god!
That almost ended tragically.
Almost. Thankfully, this is not like volcano lava. That shit ends you immediately.
Yeah, volcano lava. Just you get in it, you just go, ah! Ah!
Ah! Is this the place?
R.I.P. John Carroll Lynch. his character
this
involved.
This is not a place.
Nope. Not fucking with you guys. I'm fucking with these guys. Ah! Ow.
Well,
not accurate enough.
Unless.
Ow.
Oh no!
Oh god!
Oh,
I'm getting
bang
fucked!
I wanna just. Yeah. Okay, you're trapped there.
Fuck off! Aww.
Here's a question I have. Another question I have. What country doesn't like have its own style of animation? Or like, what country is underrepresented in like animation?
Well, what have we seen? We've seen Irish animation. We've seen Australian animation.
Australia. Oh yeah, Dr. Jekyll, Mr. Hyde.
And Marion Max was Australian. That was claymation.
Close enough. It's same spirit. Not using, like, photography to get a point across. It's using,
Oh, come on. You're supposed to go the other way.
Models.
We've seen French. We've seen Canadian with Code Lyoko and Reboot.
Korea. Korean animation is also a big thing, but it's visually indistinguishable from Japanese animation.
Korean does a lot of outsourcing in animation. Not a lot of, not as much original content.
I wonder if it would be like original Korean content.
I'm sure there is, just not as much as Japan or.
I don't have my phone on me.
Because Boondocks, all but one season was Korean animated, and the one season was Japanese animated.
Oh, Madhouse, I think.
Yeah.
But Madhouse is Japanese.
Yeah, that's what I was saying. One of the seasons was Japanese animated.
Madhouse is the only like company that's like perfectly willing to work with American studios because a lot of their properties are basically just animated versions of American properties. Like,
did they do the Dante's Inferno movie?
Which part of it?
Yeah, they did part of it.
I,
what a tragedy.
I know IG, Studio IG did a portion of it. Damn if I can figure out which one they did. Alright, no, this is actually thematically appropriate since we're on this level.
Yeah.
So, if for those of you who don't know, there is a movie based on the game Dante's Inferno, which in and of itself was based on the book, or the play, or
the
whatever.
Poem.
The what?
It was an epic poem.
A poem.
By the way, spawned the Italian language. Italian did not exist as a language before Dante's Divine Comedy.
Yes. So we saw the movie, and for whatever reason, they decided that they were going to do it, anthology style?
They were going to have it animated by a bunch of different unrelated groups.
Yes.
And they, without consistent character design.
Yeah, the character design is all over the place. Like, first section of the movie, Dante looked like
Guts.
Like, no,
right?
No, that's the third section.
Oh.
The first section, he looked like a crusader dude.
Oh.
Like, he was wearing armor and stuff.
Yeah.
And Virgil.
Virgil was bald?
I think?
I remember there was a big difference because at one point Virgil was bald and at one point he looked like a wishing troll.
Hey, oh wait, what about the time, what about the final Virgil appearance where he just looked like an alien for no reason?
Yeah, there was also that one.
Yeah, so, first one he looked like a crusader, second time Dante looked like fucking Nathan Explosion.
Yes, yes he did.
Then he looked like Guts, and then it kind of blurs together.
Yeah.
I do, however, wholeheartedly, if you can't find it, watch Dante's Inferno. It is amazing.
It was amusing in it for its own reasons.
Just like
they also did. That was the way they did the Animatrix, but that actually was an anthology.
That was an anthology. There was like. No,
and they also did a Batman series of movies that way, Batman series that way. I don't know if that was an anthology or not.
First Death. Batman stuff?
Yeah.
I think that was somewhat related, but not totally?
Yeah. I know it had Man Bat in it.
No, Animatrix was a total, like, anthology piece. One happened to be, like, a prequel to, like, the second movie, but the rest were just kind of like, you know, oh, this takes place in the same universe. There's nothing wrong with it.
Yeah.
One of them was done by the same guy who did Aeon Flux.
Yeah.
And if you watched Aeon Flux, you could tell, because the main character in that one is literally just Aeon Flux.
Kids Next Door parodied the Animatrix of all things.
They did. They parodied two of them. Like, because one of them was like split up into two parts for some reason. But
one of the things in Animatrix.
Yeah, one of the things in Animatrix, and I watched the Animatrix first.
Yeah,
I watched it as a kid, which, you know, my parents, I like the fact that they trusted me enough to like, hey, you can watch this, and then I watched that episode of Kids Next Door. I'm like, this is just the fucking Animatrix.
Why is there a wooden log in Lethal Lava Land?
Maybe it's not.
Maybe it's petrified wood.
That's weird. You're.
I'm getting madder than a beaver in a petrified forest.
Nice clayism.
Yeah, that was one of the better ones.
Yeah, basically, I'll tell you, because just for context, the Kids Next Door one is like, kids used to rule the world, and now thanks to adults, they didn't.
We've unlocked an even more broken method of travel.
And basically, that part of the Animatrix was just, oh, here's the lore. Here's how things got the way they were in the Matrix. And a lot of like the key moments in Kids Next Door, that it's out of order, like the stuff that happened, but they do touch upon some of the major like character arcs in that. And yeah, to this day I have no idea why they decided to do it the way they did.
Fuck.
Oh no.
Well, so much for that. Now I have to travel level the boring way.
You have to triple jump over there, or do you just do that?
Actually, I'm gonna get these first. Oh, okay, you dick!
But just to be clear, the Animatrix is totally not for kids, and that one in particular, that short was violent as fuck.
Yeah.
Like,
I saw the I saw Sausage Party DVDs for sale at Walmart.
Oh, we got.
And I had a flashback back to the days of VHS anime. It had a big, big logo on it that said, not for children.
Oh, fuck yeah. I heard there was some nasty shit in Sausage Party. Not like terrible, just like, no, don't want, it's not for kids.
But it has a very deep philosophical meaning to it.
I wouldn't go that far, I just say that it's
not. According to my brother.
Oh, Sean?
No, my older, the 35-year-old one.
Oh, yeah.
Said that. I mean, maybe it does. South Park has some pretty good points to make despite its crude package. I just thought that was a funny thing to hear about it.
It's got a really deep philosophical meaning. I'm guessing it has to do about... has to...
the nature of existence.
To talking about religion.
Maybe.
I wouldn't be surprised.
Notice me, senpai. Notice me!
Yandere Simulator. Are we ever playing that?
I mean, we could. I don't know anything about it as a game, other than that it's popular.
The guy who designed it got his inspiration from the Hitman series, and that basically sold me on it immediately.
Yeah.
It's the same kind of, like, hiding in plain sight, stealth kind of thing.
Oh.
That's another game I gotta play on stream is Hitman.
My only opinion on Yandere Simulator is that I'm mad that it got a lot of popularity and Artificial Academy 2 didn't.
Well, again, Artificial Academy 2 would be really popular if they excised all the porn bits.
Yeah.
I'm not saying it's like the correct opinion to have. In fact, I really don't believe in correct opinions, but...
is it an accurate one?
It's accurate. People aren't ready for porn to be mainstream.
Yet!
Not yet. We're waiting for that one porn film to win an Oscar.
Waiting for the other shoe to drop. Although technically, by a lot of people's definition, if it wins an Oscar, then it's by definition not porn.
What is the thing about porn? Like, I can't define it, but I'll know it when I see it.
I don't necessarily agree with this definition, but the one I was given was content that has, like, no artistic value besides being sexual.
Oh. Well, then in that case, Watch the Girl Quest isn't a porn.
No.
Because it's got content other than just the sex. Just the sex. Yeah.
And Night Shift Nurses isn't a porn.
Well, then by that definition, Transformers is porn.
Yeah. Michael Bay movies kind of have that quality to them. Fuck, I'm gonna die.
No, yeah, you are. You're too risky on this level.
Well, I didn't want to face the bully.
Well, you could just run around him a little bit till the platforms came on. It's fine, you're doing well.
I got my broken turtle shell. Honestly, I probably don't need to fuss with the little bullies. Their single coins aren't necessary.
Not necessary, no, but helpful.
Oh, can I? I can!
Oh yeah, fuck that's you! Right! You're invincible on the shell!
Eat it! Eat it, you bitches!
Careful you don't, like, run into the wall, though.
Yeah. I think someone... Maybe it was just a YouTube video. I saw a YouTube video of the Yandere Sim girl in Smash Brothers. I don't know if she was actually modded in or if that was just someone made a fake splash screen for her.
There's no way because that game is all about murdering
in
people.
Smash Bros. Infinite or something. I mean, obviously a fan effort.
Yeah. I could see. They were able to mod in. I guess they did actually.
Oh, I'm not invulnerable to that?
Guess not. Oh, well.
Well, at least I died, or I got hit as good a place as any.
You should always go for the bridge first.
Yeah, I should. That was a mistake. So I'm minus 5 coins.
Yeah, hopefully more than make up for it. You probably are gonna have to go inside the volcano.
Well, yeah, you have to do that anyway. There's not 100 coins outside the volcano.
You could try to, like, go under the bridge with the cap.
What, you were just saying I was too risky?
Well, I mean, yeah, but if you're gonna do it, just fuck it, right?
Motherfucker!
Yeah, I knew you could do it!
Nope, okay.
When you succeed well. When you fail spectacularly.
Yep, that's what makes a good streamer.
Yep.
No. Damn it. Fuck
you. Got him!
Divine retribution.
So...
healing money.
People really didn't like No Man's Sky.
No, they didn't.
I've never played No Man's Sky. I was kind of like enthralled by the E3 thing, but
I never saw it. I missed the hype. I missed the hype completely.
Well,
fuck! There's an island out there.
You're spared from the disappointment and heartache that a lot of other people. People are saying they got ripped off.
Ah, fuck.
This level's just kicking your ass.
Well, the 100 coins bit anyway. Alright, come on. Turtle shell. This level has so many islands.
Oh, I mean...
More islands than One Piece, yo! No, nothing has more islands than One Piece. Not even Wind Waker.
One Piece was a world of islands.
Yep.
Well, then again, yeah. Well, no, I presume that Wind Waker takes place in the same universe as One Piece.
Yeah.
There's a giant flood. It's not like there's gonna be a mainland that's just magically okay because of it.
Notice me!
Like, by the way, the guy who does Yandere Sim,
he
has like a blog, and like a video blog he does, like talking about the game.
Yeah.
And he's like one of the most soft-spoken dudes you've ever heard.
Does it still like update?
Oh no, he's still actively working on it.
Oh, is it in beta?
Yeah, it's an open beta. It's also free.
Wow, it's been that way for a long time.
Like, I thought the fat has had passed, and it's not even released yet.
I think
people are kind of jumping the gun on going into this alpha-beta thing a bit early these days.
Well, here's the thing. You can either pay some QA guys to test it, but opinions should always be free.
Like, that's true, but it from just like,
I mean, okay.
From an advertising perspective, you're blowing your load, you're blowing your game's, you know, mojo before it's out.
People know that it's not, that it's like alpha slash beta slash gamma.
They
slash
do,
whatever.
Right, but.
And so,
if you blow your load before the features, you're gonna miss your opportunity to sell the game.
Maybe he doesn't want to sell it. Maybe he's just like, maybe he's content with just having it be like a freeware game he can just work on. Maybe it's practice for him.
For the upcoming Tsundere simulator.
Tsundere simulator. I'd rather play Madden on SNES. Oh, did it run out?
No, I ended it.
Okay.
I'm gonna get the red coins, and I'm gonna get that eye, and then I'm gonna go in the volcano. The easiest red coins in the game.
Well, nobody's that sadistic.
Fuck. Thank God you don't have to do this slide puzzle yourself. Slide puzzles suck.
How would that work?
Exactly.
You jump on it and just moves.
Also, good thing that you can do the triple jump while stationary with a wing cap. Nice little usability feature.
Yeah.
Okay, 76.
Are you ready?
Wow.
Are you ready for Volcano?
Into the maw.
Into the vortex. Into the void. Become
nothing, like the wind. Oh, there's still stuff.
You almost blew your load. You really don't like the whole concept of open betas.
No, I was just saying, it's not all positive.
Wait,
it's got downsides, too. What?
Behind you, there's an island. With coins.
Yeah, with nothing on it.
With coins! Okay. I saw coins on it! So what are you saying?
I mean, it's got its downsides, too. It's not a perfect system.
I mean, yeah, nothing really is, but... if people see that you're regularly making progress to get your game better and, like, get features that people are asking for, then that really, like, helps out a lot. Because
yeah.
You can tailor your game to, like, how people kind of feel about it in general. You can get consistency as to what's good rather than just kind of either have, like, shots in the dark or, like... rely on people that are paid to tell you everything's A-okay.
I mean, it's not really... that's not what testers are paid to do at all, but okay.
Well, in theory, no, but an asshole can just, like, hire them, and then if they're not liking what they're hearing, they can just fire them.
I guess.
I'm not saying it's right, I'm saying it can happen. You did it.
I don't think it would ever happen because that would defeat the entire... if someone were to do that, they would just not hire testers
okay.
Is what they would do.
I would say that no company would be stupid enough to do that, but then again, we live in a company in which TNA exists.
Okay. TNA does not make video games, to my knowledge.
TNA is also a shitty company.
Yeah?
They make stupid fucking... EA. Another example, EA.
Okay. I don't think EA would do that either. I don't think anyone would be that stupid.
Oh, you sweet summer child!
Except maybe you for positing this idea.
What? Why would I... I say it's a stupid idea to do that! Why would I be the one to do it? I'm noticing you're not answering my question!
Not really the point, but okay. Oh, I missed. I'm gonna die.
No, you're not.
I said I was gonna die, goddammit.
I'm gonna prove myself right, and I don't care what it takes to do it. Jumps into lava.
That's okay, I got the 100. Oh, okay, it starts us right here.
Yeah, that's a nice little feature.
I think this is the same interior music they used for the inside of the pyramid, too.
Yeah, it's vaguely,
Egyptian.
Yes.
You know, Egypt, known for its volcanoes.
Yeah, you're right. There are no volcanoes in Egypt. I was actually legitimately thinking, wait, are there actually any volcanoes in Egypt? I'm sure there might be one.
Maybe.
Like one dead one.
This would be a lot easier if the cameras were better in this game.
Yeah.
Oh, look, the remains of the fire temple.
We nuked the fire temple. I get whatever happened to the fire temple. I guess it just kind of stayed there.
I guess.
It's like nothing really happened to it.
I mean, that's the case with most of the temples. They stay there after you complete them.
Yeah, nobody really just,
They don't blow up the temples afterwards. Just thought it'd be a good idea to take some damage there.
I've never had anybody have so much trouble getting on a surfboard before.
Hold on, I got this. Can I take it with me?
No. Are you trying to cheat it?
It wouldn't matter. It's not like you can use it in here.
Well, not effectively for this star.
No. Wouldn't be very effective trying to go up the side either, though.
More effective than trying to stay stationary on this platform.
Yeah.
Actually, you need to drop it when you would get to the,
the poles.
Yeah. So.
Whoa! Aw, oh, I was too.
Are you serious?
I nudged a bit too much. I thought maybe I can make it.
You can start off in here. That's handy dandy.
Whatever happened to Joe?
Joe the plumber?
No, Steve joined a pirate metal band. Never heard about Joe after the end of Blue's Clues.
What?
Steve said, fuck this, I'm a pirate.
Oh, wait, you're talking about Blue's Clues?
Yeah. Because he just said, hey.
Wait, Steve, okay. The guy who was the first guy in Blue's Clues.
Left Blue's Clues to join a pirate metal band.
Hailstorm?
No, not that.
Wait, there's more than one metal pirate band?
Look up the guy from Blue's Clues, see what band he joined.
My phone's not on me. I'll have to wait until...
Or it might be his band. I think it was.
That's pretty cool. You're right. I've never watched any Joe episodes.
I don't remember doing so.
Joe always struck me, from what little I saw of that, as the kind of person who was like, you know, henpecked. Like a henpecked husband kind of deal.
Okay. Just we're missing one in Jolly Roger Bay. We needed the...
Metal cap.
Yeah.
We'll take care of that. Oh, the rabbit!
Is there a second rabbit star?
That's the one.
No, I already got the one.
Oh. You did? I guess I wasn't paying attention.
Yeah, you blinked and missed it.
You'll have to double check the footage, because I don't remember you catching the rabbit.
Because you blinked and missed it.
Yep.
Not you again! Okay, yeah, there is a second one.
Oh, that's good.
Who's giving this rabbit these stars?
Bowser, obviously.
You look trustworthy.
Here's two stars. Kill Mario.
Gonna be the most powerful rabbit in existence.
See, the stars themselves can't be that powerful individually. If those were jewel shards, that rabbit would be a fucking monster.
Oh, yeah. Like, oh, Shikon Jewel. Here are two Shikon Jewel shards. You become a demon now.
Or I'm trying to think of other series that had, like, power imbuing bits.
Fuck. I don't know. Like, if it was like... I don't know, like... Here's some Red Eye, Rabbit! Take out Mario! Oh, I see you're living in my castle, huh? Here's the Philosopher's Stone. Kill Mario.
Considering how... I guess that was a thing with the Chaos Emeralds, too. They didn't have any power except together. Like, the...
Well, that depends on who you ask, because Shadow was able to, like, fucking teleport and shit, and he only had one.
Yeah, that's true. I mean, the frog ate one, and nothing happened to him at all.
Well, it's because he didn't know how to use it.
Oh, okay.
Wait, which frog are you talking about?
Froggy?
That frog.
That was a character?
You never played Sonic Adventure 1.
No, I haven't.
Oh, okay. Well, you can look forward to the frog character.
Oh, the frog.
Not an anthropomorphic frog, just a literal frog.
That's weird.
Running up walls!
The music just kind of came in all at once.
Yeah. We'll get you. When we play Sonic Adventure 1, we'll get to introduce you to the glory that is Big the Cat's first appearance.
Oh, God. Heard so much about Big the Cat. That he's big. And that he's a cat.
That's about his whole character.
I'm a big cat!
Oh! I love playing games. Having input. Doing things. There we go. No. No. No.
Fuck.
Teleportation powers, save me! No, not this time.
Nope. You suddenly just get kicked out to the world and you lose life and you wonder how the fuck did that happen.
We'll get to that.
What? When?
This episode? No, not this episode. That's kinda related to a bug.
Okay.
Oh! Speaking of bugs, the next level has some fun ones.
Alright, show them off when you can.
Nah, I've waited too long. I gotta get the right angle and go immediately. Respawn! There we go. Okay. Speedrun!
Trek's just tilting it forward.
I am, but I don't think it does anything. Yeah. I should have hit the button and crossed the switch to get a little more land distance. There we go.
Nice job! Well, that takes care of that. One more and we can fight the boss, I think.
No, that's... I think it's 70.
Alright. Oh, you got a little over halfway of all the total stars? That's good enough! That's what we call good enough.
Yeah. What a... No longer Nintendo hard. We've changed.
Then again, I guess in Super Mario World, you could only, like, fight, like, 8 stages tops before you got to the final boss.
Super Mario World was probably the easiest Mario game.
Yeah, that was in the fucking title!
Yeah.
This game is fucking easy. I'm glad you agree with me, finally, because you had some doubts.
How many times... No, I didn't have doubts, but... How many times did you get game overs by the end of it?
A lot.
Yeah.
I didn't say I was good at it, I just said that... Like, I probably have a lot of trouble doing this level.
Yeah, this is also gonna suck for the 100 coins.
Fuck.
And it has the semi-gruesome drowning in sand death.
Drowning in sand, what that...
Okay.
Can you imagine?
Oh, I need to act.
That's a horrible way to die.
Yeah.
It's like...
That was the most terrifying death in the live-action Jungle Book movie.
Oh! Guy
who got buried.
You saw that one too? I love that movie.
Yeah.
Like, there
that
were,
was
okay,
scary shit as a child.
There were actually two dead sand-like deaths. There's the one guy who sunk in quicksand. He's like, "Help me! Help me!" The guy's like, "I'm trying," and something broke. And then with the last thing he said before he got like quicksanded was, "God damn you!" And he just dies. He just goes under the quicksand.
Yeah,
that poke is good.
There was the quicksand death, and there was the not.
My leg! I can't get out! Ah! And then the whole thing just kind of falls on top of him.
Yeah. That was the crushing sand death. That was the one I was talking about.
Yeah, that one was fucking crazy. That is a kids movie.
Yep. Well, don't know if it was necessarily a kids movie, but kids watched it.
Kids were... it was on a channel which the primary demographic was children. Oh no! Oh, I remember this!
All the way up, all the way to the left.
Yeah, I remember this. Undead Mario!
I have no life.
Can you get the star?
I must die, but I have no animation. Just I flying around at no health.
I have no animation and I must die.
I could get the star if I was really, if I was on point.
Which star?
The in the pyramid star.
Oh yeah. What was this? You have to not. Oh! 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 Just missed!
Yeah. As soon as you touch down, you instantly die. This is an interesting little bug.
Yeah. Computers do what you tell them to do. They won't do what you want.
Oh, and the talons of the big bird was this one, actually.
Well, you know. Alright. I just mentioned that one because...
You can do them in any order.
That was the only one you could reasonably get as Undead Mario.
Yeah. I'm coming for you, bird!
I can fly, too.
Uh-oh, losing altitude. Walls? Meh.
That's so weird! Like, Mario can't do that shit anywhere else!
Nope. Bird. Get over here. Bird. Bird. There we go. And now the bird is forever pissed at us. And will steal our hat.
You stole my star!
That was a weird mechanic for them to include in the game, just the hat stealing.
The hat is hatless
Mario.
The hat is the source of Mario's power.
We could do that for it. It's just like Paper Mario. He has the hat as his defense.
Gosh.
We could do that as challenge mode. They play this game as hatless Mario.
So the first time I played this game, it was zoned by my grandmother.
It was zoned?
It was owned.
Oh.
Like, okay. By my grandmother. Like, my grandmother owned it.
Yeah.
And I played this, and I was playing it, and I started on my grandmother's save file, because I just kind of wanted to explore the castle a little bit.
Yeah.
And I realized, something's up with Mario's head. Something's not quite right, and I looked and I realized, where the fuck's his hat?
She had lost the hat and didn't realize how to get it back?
Yeah.
Well, I guess it's just gone forever.
Right, okay, but my grandmother was also the kind of person to intentionally avoid checkpoints in Donkey Kong Country, so maybe she just intentionally lost it to give herself an extra challenge.
Yeah, that's a pretty badass grandma.
Yeah. I'm like, as a kid, like, why aren't you going for the checkpoints? She's like, that's too easy. Alright.
I think she played Mario World with her hands tied and her eyes closed.
I don't know. She might have. I'm sure if Call of Duty was around, she'd be playing that in the hardest difficulty. And would intentionally use the pistol.
Nah, fuck that. Melee.
Knife everybody to death. You could have pulled that off of, like, the World War II Call of Duties. The future Call of Duties are more involved.
Yeah. Was not very useful, but I will say Unreal Tournament had one of the coolest melee weapons, the Steam Hammer.
Oh yeah, it's just like a piston.
Yeah.
The original Unreal Tournament.
Well, Unreal Tournament 3 was. Oh no, no! Get back here!
Hey, you retrieved it.
Running.
How long have we been going for? Oh, we've been going over an hour. We gotta get to Spyro.
Yeah.
I'm going for the 100 coin star. Damn it. Okay, that's one coin down. So I'll try to get that and one star, and then I guess we'll switch to Spyro.
Yeah. That sounds fair. Now I know. Now we know how Vinny feels. Just plays a game for like so long.
Oh wait, I wasn't planning to go this long.
Yeah. Oh shit! It's 3 a.m. I gotta get to work. Although I don't think Vinny actually.
No, not anymore. He's just streaming.
He's living the dream. I mean, if I could make all my money just playing games online, I totally would take that in a heartbeat.
Yeah.
Who wouldn't?
That'd be pretty great. Oh no.
Anyway.
Fuck. I need that.
You put on the hat. The mist. I'm trying to remember if there was any, what other, like, games had, like, stereotypical, Egyptian pyramid environments.
Was there one in, the level like that in Banjo?
Yeah, there was Shifting Sandland.
Isn't that what this is?
Fuck.
Is it the same name in both games?
I'm not 100% confident then in what, I know there was a desert level in that one, and you do go into a pyramid.
Yeah.
To, like, raid it for a jiggy. And,
I'm trying to think if, like, Croc had one.
Oh, God.
I don't remember Croc very well, though.
Oh, that's a good choice not to remember Croc. Perfectly acceptable choice.
We are gonna have to stream it, though. At one point.
Are we?
With Omniplay.
Hell yeah! No, when you put it like that, yeah, we are streaming it.
It's just a weird enough feature that's not included in any other game for us not to stream.
It's not included in any other game for good reason.
Yeah.
Well, except for Octodad.
Yeah, that has it.
No!
I got it.
Okay, good. You do not lose the hat from that.
No.
Of course, Tomb Raider, it has a pyramid.
Yeah.
Yeah, that was the main thing with, But the first one wasn't actually a pyramid. The first tomb she rode in, like, Tomb Raider. It was
Get it!
Oh no, the hat's gone!
We're now Hatless Mario.
Hatless Mario run. He keeps his hair really nice, by the way. Yeah, doesn't he take double damage without the hat?
I don't know if it's double. I know he takes more damage.
No, it's double. I'm pretty sure it's double.
Yeah. Look, I got my hat back.
Perfect run, Mario. You gonna go inside the pyramid?
Yeah, I'm wondering if there's any more corns I can get out here. I think there's some at this... That corner of the pyramid!
Nice going, dumbass!
So, is that the end of the video?
We
gotta get to Spyro.
We lost the hat. We lost the star.
Mario's looking sexy. Mission accomplished.
Alright, we'll get to Spyro.
We'll be right back with Spyro the Dragon.